Well, welcome to Madden 17, week one, and that is for a bit of a reason. Unfortunately, all the career mode I've been doing, well, I played it all in one day. I thought autosave was on, so I just turned it off. Yeah, apparently I don't have that anymore. So that series that was going on isn't there anymore. I don't know how it happened. I have put autosave on now, so it should be okay now. And then I had a decision to make after that. I do apologise that it's not there. So the decision I had to make was quite simple: start again or try franchise mode out. And I thought, I haven't actually done that yet, so I thought I'll try out franchise mode now, see how it goes, and possibly bring back another career mode later on. So I am going to be Tampa Bay Buccaneers, have to be, that's who I support, you know, seriously. But first job to do, set the season goals. Let's see, pretty much the same thing as before. More aggressive you're with the goal, the higher your reward. So what do you want? We've got Falcons, Bears, Chiefs. It's going to be a difficult one. You're not very confident in an expected challenging season. See if I go make the Super Bowl there. I think, to be honest with you, this season is going to be a tough one. I'd be happy with 7 wins at the moment. Let's go with that. I'm going to do that when you're not there, because, to be quite honest with you, you guys don't want to watch the weekly training or anything like that. So first of all, got a trade offer. Let's review this offer for Charles Sims and what we've got. So the halfback Charles Sims, 82 overall. Chicago want to give me C. Jones, 72, while also giving me round 5 and round 6 draft picks over the next 2 years. Washington give me Crowder, wide receiver, that's the one, also giving me 2 picks over the next 2 years. Indianapolis want to give me Harrison, 75 overall and 1 draft pick for next year. And Cleveland want to give me 2 draft picks in 2 years. Great. I think out of them, the most one that I'm most promising and looking at would be Crowder. But first of all, let's go have a look at our halfback situations. Let's go have a look at the team. My team, and I want to have a look at the depth charts, to be quite honest with you, with the halfbacks. Quarterbacks. Ed Glennon is a backup with Griffin there as well. But halfbacks, what we got? So we got Doug Martin, Charles Sims III, followed by Jay Rodgers, who's had 5 years. He's only 2 years. It's the wide receiver that I want to have a look at. So you've got Evans, Jackson, Cecil Shorts 3. I could make the change. Halfbacks. Doug Martin's going to be playing most of it. Wide receiver. Could do with him. You know what, I'm actually gonna be stupid. I know you're probably saying, don't do it. I'm actually going to review this offer. Select that. Yep. 1 draft pick next season and a draft pick in 2 years. And Jay Crowder. Um Yeah, let's do it. Done it. Trade offer was accepted. Browner now comes into the team. Halfback Charles Sims, 25 years old, 82 overall. Wide receiver James Crowder, 23 years old, so 2 years younger at least. We have him for a bit longer. At 76 overall, better than we thought. And two draft picks over the next 2 years. Acknowledge that, there we go. Let's have a look at improving this team. Don't need a quarterback because I'm quite happy with Jameis Winston. And they're not free there. Sort of trade. They're all to be traded, so. Let's see. FB is somewhere where we're a bit weak at the moment. 73 overall. Age 32. I'd rather be signing someone a bit younger. So I think we're going to leave that for now. C's, B's, or D. There'll be two. I think we might try for this. Well, they want a wide receiver. You want CB? Well, let's see if we can something here. Add a player. No. Go right down. Because we just had a just brought a wide receiver in. Don't want to give him them. Not at the moment. I'll give him one probably for next year. They want a wide receiver. So how about you have El Murphy? I'll give you the last pick for next year. There we go. Last pick for next year. See if that. Their interest is low in all of that, so let's submit the offer and see what happens. Oh, it's a yellow, so they might be interested. Oh, did they not go for it? Submit this offer? What happened? Oh, the Eagles are not interested in El Murphy. Okay, well, we're going to have to go into the season without. Very. What's his overall? 61. Is anyone here? Oh, well, we go. We'll sign him then. Signed to active roster, 1 year. Yeah, we'll take him. There we go. So that's looking a little bit fresher there. Oh, that's pretty good then. Why is wide receiver 2B? It's Vincent Jackson. Well, okay. I think at the moment, leave it as that. And Jake Crowder comes in. Doug Martin, Stocker, it's Jackson. Oh yeah, there we go. I think at the moment, I'm quite happy with that. Evans and Stocker, Jackson. Yeah. The defense. Jared McCoy in the middle. Donald Golson, Ayers Jr. And in the back line, looking pretty good specialists. He's a good kicker, good punter. Yep. Practice squad. Okay, that's fine with me. Not that I really know exactly what's going on. So now, anyway, what I'm going to do now is I'm going to go and set up the weekly training. Come back. Well, when I come back, we'll be at the Georgia Dome, taking on the Atlanta Falcons.
Opening week in the NFL is an exciting time for everybody, including these two teams here today. It's the Buccaneers going up against the Falcons. With that, let's get over to Atlanta as we welcome in our brand new broadcast pairing for 2016.
Oh, here we go then. Tampa Bay, Atlanta Falcons. Huge matchup for the rivals. It's going to be a tough one for both teams. It's definitely going to be the case. But I know if we put everything into it, we go for it, we will come out with a win today. Of course, I'm playing those play moments. So, when I mean the play moments, they're starting with the ball. So we'll go with the simming part that, as you see from the last series, is there. And we'll come in when it's in the last, into the end, going towards the end zone, the red zone. All of crucial moments. Of course, I can speed it up, but we want to see where we're going, don't we? Because they've received it, they're moving forwards. I will take over defense and also the offense. But we've got our first play moment, so let's get in there. Let's see. Third and five, we can stop them. Can we stop them in this first game? Third and five, big opportunity now. And off we go. Turning round him, and it's blocked. Tipped off. Fourth and five. Brilliant. Getting the ball back early and having a chance to move forward. It was nowhere near him. Just reached up and picked it off. Maybe he could have actually picked it up. Continue to next moment. Fourth and fifth. And it's a touchback, so back on 25. Oh, we're already on. Coaching suggestions. The flanker drive. What can Jameis Winston do here then? First time out. Here we go then. Put it up. Oh, he just drops it. Starting off badly. Second and 10 now.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
Right, and on with the running game then this time. Second and 10. Moving forward. And taken down. 3 yards. Now we need to find 7 yards on this third play. Otherwise, it's a very quick three and out. We saw the Doug Martin. We're going with that deep attack then. 1400 yards second only to Adrian Peterson last year. And he really helped a young quarterback. Here we go then. By taking a lot of pressure off of him. Now he feels good coming off that 5-year deal he signed in March. That's it. And run. There we go. First down. We can move the sticks. A misdirection shot then. They might have picked up a good one here, maybe a little dive. 1 for 2 on the passing, 50% at the moment. A new city, maybe different motivation, but they believe they've got a good one. Put it up for him. Take it. He got it. Brilliant catch. They'll get 19 yards there. I was getting under pressure, had to let go of it. And really did leave it up for a chance to get any Evans, taking that one beautifully into one hand. Brilliant one-handed catch. There we go, we're going with the stick then. We're in their half. Let's keep this moving. Here we go. Over the top. And there's another first down. We're keeping this moving. Now we're going to turn to the running game again. See if we can get any more out of this running. Don't need to rush. We can take our time. But it just collapsed again. Couldn't find a gap to run to, and it's second and 10 again. Let's see. Can we pick what I was practicing? No. Okay. Let's go with it then. Go with what you think, coach. And off we go. On, that's it. Forcing over for that first down. Jameis Winston doing well today.
And this is why trying to cover the angle route is so difficult. Anyone
54 passing yards. And we're moving towards the red zone. Can we get there before the end of this quarter? Here we go. Oh, he's over the top. Go on. Is that enough? 10 yards. That's another first down. Keep it moving. I don't see us doing it before the end of the quarter, but at least we're here, we're there. Oh, go on, Martin. Go on. He's done it. Touchdown. Running into the touchdown. And Tampa Bay take that early lead. Well, not so early. It's the first quarter, but brilliantly run through. Nice blockers in there, allowing Doug Martin to run in for the touchdown. And continue to the next moment, going for that point after, and it's good, 7-0 then. Here we go, over to defense to try and do something for us. 12-yard reception, so they're moving it. That's the end of the first quarter, into the second quarter now. 4-yard rush. Second and 6, pass dropped. Third and 6, 4-yard rush. Fourth and 1, 37-yard punt. 1-yard punt return. First and 10, 4-yard rush from Doug Martin. Second and 6, 6-yard rush from Doug Martin. And we're moving it forward. Jameis Winston still doing it. And Jamie Crowder, our newest guy, taking that catch for that one. Doug Martin, full of confidence now, running beautifully with the ball. Jackie's Rogers actually moving the ball as well now. I wonder if Doug Martin got injured on one of those plays, did he? I can't remember seeing it. Jameis Crowder proving how good he can be, but a penalty on the offense. First and 20, 8-yard reception, Safarian Jenkins. 4-yard rush from Rogers. And with third down alert, take control and keep the drive alive. Let's see if we can't do it. Third and 8. We need to find 8 yards on this one to keep this drive alive and go 14 in the lead. Putting it up. Oh, damn. Why? God damn it, I've given the ball away to them for these last 2 minutes and they'll probably get back in the game now. Oh, couldn't widely put his feet out of play. Not good. Not a clever bit of play there. Back to throwing interceptions again. There you go, to the next moment. Missed out on that chance. Hopefully, oh, wait a minute. It's an interception. Red zone alert. Well, thankfully, they threw an interception themselves, so we've got 1 yard. As long as we don't throw the interception, we should go to the running game after this one. Go on, there it is. Another touchdown. 14-0. Doug Martin getting a rushing touchdown. Jameis Winston now getting a passing touchdown. We are on a roll in this first half. Look at the space Safarian Jenkins had. No one on him. Easy catch for him. And we are in the lead. That'll take us back to this play the moment. Simming. Extra point is good. 14-0. Now back to the defense. Can you stop them in these last 2 minutes? An incomplete pass. Third and 5. 7 yards, they're going to get another fresh downs. Another incomplete pass, though. Another incomplete pass. Third and 10, 15 yards. And the clock will continue. Another incomplete pass, keep it going. Second and 10, incomplete pass. Go on, just do it one more time. One more time. Yes, there we go. But are they going to go for it on fourth down? No, they're punting it. Let's just 2 minute drill, get some points. I don't know, I think I'm happy just to run this clock down if we can, to be honest with you. with two touchdowns in the lead going into the half. Don't want to muck it up, and well, not taking a catch will be a problem because we can't run the clock down if we don't. Let's try it again then. Second and 10 on our own goal line as well, making it that little bit more difficult. And oh my god, what have I done? The defense doing such a good job for me. I've just gone and almost panicked and thrown it. I thought maybe he was in a good position to get it over, but then I accidentally held the button down and threw it straight into the hands. Oh, that's stupid. Well, let's get into the half one touchdown up at least. Hopefully, unless they get the ball running and going. 2 minutes and get some points. I'm back on. Okay. I didn't actually see what happened there, but we're back on. Let's at least get into the half up. Oh, for God's sake. How do I keep doing this? What am I doing wrong? I thought he was actually open. But I'm giving them... When I looked at him, Crowder was in front of him, ready to go. Then he ends up behind him. How? Well, back to his play moments and hope that the defense do something. I'm not sure. Oh, they're right up there. It's not good. Incomplete pass. Block the field goal. Let's see if we can't do it. And... ready, go. Nope. Get down. Nope. They're back within 4 points now. Here we go. Let's get to the half. 2 minutes. You'll get some points. Why do we keep saying get some points? Let's just get the clock down. Here we go. Oh, what? I didn't fumble it. I was throwing it. Come on. I must have been on the throw on that one. Let's go over to Gerald McCoy. And... and blocked. First and goal. I can't believe I've done this to Tampa Bay. After all the preparation, all the practice, a play like that will absolutely break. Thrown it away right at the end. We were doing so well. In the end zone, a big time drop. And thrown it away. Third and goal then. Maybe a wise call not to take a sack in this part of the field. It brings up. Let's make sure. It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we come on. If someone's trying to throw the ball, and you can put. And it's a touchdown. Touchdown, Falcons. They will take the lead for the half. From 8 yards out, and the Falcons. Oh my, this 2 minutes has been terrible. And it's not like I've been terrible the whole time. I actually got two touchdowns earlier. It's still a lead, and that always feels good. Okay, next moment. Extra point is good. We're now 3 points behind. Can we move into a position to get a field goal, maybe? 6 yard rush. Second and 4, 8 yards. First and 10, incomplete pass. He threw it away. Second and 10, pass. Knocked away. Third and 10, sacked. Well, it's not just me getting these problems in. And a 45-yard punt. 8 seconds to stop them, and there it is, half time. Into the second half, and kick off, touchback, and we start on our own 25. And James Winston sacked again. Second and 14, 5 yard rush. Third and 9, 5 yards. Well done, Winston. Fourth and 5, 42 yard punt. 1 yard punt return. I mean, how has it gone so bad? I mean, I think I was actually doing those things up the field and it was all working well. Oh, thank goodness for that interception. We can still win it though. One touchdown is all that's needed. 26 yard reception and we're into the red zone. Here we go then. A chance. We can do this. And just trying to get away, but the Atlanta Falcons are pushing. Pushing well. Kind of need to look at all areas of the pitch now, not just be focused on one. He's going over. He's got it. And touchdown. Looking all over the field that time and saw a nice pass to Evans. And we take the lead back again. 2017. Right, at the moment it's 2017. Hopefully it'll be 21-17. See if I can put it into in front of him, then I can do well. Not play a ball over when the defender's in front. You know, that's where I've been going wrong, I think. Oh, here we go. Let's make sure we hold on to this defense. 5 yards. Come on, we can stop him. We can stop him. 6 yards. First and 10. Okay, still got another 6 to go. That's more than 6. Oh, Jesus. How did we collapse and let them through? It's certainly not a bad game so far. 21-24. First and 10, 4 yard rush from Doug Martin. Come on, Doug Martin, keep going. Third and 1, get over. Oh, you. Why are you going for the pass on that occasion? Now we need to stop him again. I thought there'd be more play moments than this in it. But we will actually play full on the whole games at some point when I manage to stop throwing the game away, maybe. I will definitely play them more off, play some more. I mean, we're in the red zone alert again. Can we take advantage of field position and get some points? Come on then. I think we're going with a running game, powering it, looking to power on through. They run again on first down. Come on, Martin. No, not this time. Second and 9, though. I think we know by now that every run is not going to be broken and get all the way to the end zone. That play that we've been. You still have their value. You can still set up your play action and throw the football. You control the clock because you have the ball and they don't. And often the physicality sets the tempo for the game. I can't even remember what it was called. Oh, I'll have to go to the coaching suggestion. I can't even remember what it was that I trained. Put them in a bad spot here. Damn it. Now Jameis on second down. Come on, throw it up. No. There just wasn't anyone open in there. All defenders get tired of hearing about their lack of hands and why they're playing. Okay, we're running there. Slants across the field now. It was the hands that made the play. Third and 9. Hopefully we won't need to go for that field goal. He's in space. Oh, just not quite getting there. Fourth and 1. Do you reckon go for the run? Oh, we can go for the run and get 1 yard. I'm sure we can. Got past one, but couldn't get past the second. It's a field goal, 21 yard field goal. I can't imagine anyone missing from 21 yards, really. It's up, and there we go. 24 all. The moment, if it stays like this, we're going to overtime in the first match of the season. Tell you the life of a kicker. He has not been called on the entire game. He's over there by the net, but they send him out here in the fourth quarter and say, hey, go tie the game, will you? We're tied up then. We came away with a score. We got points. It's the main point about that. We got points. 20 yard return. 5 yards. We need to stop them. They need to get to the other end. We need to stop them. And we have stopped them. 4th and 2. Punch. We've got the ball back. Nice fair catch call. 1st and 10 then. Come on in, Doug Martin. Get us forward. Nice one, Doug Martin. Big end of game drive. Get a score for the lead. Let's keep it going, Doug Martin. Five broken tackles already this year for him. That's nicely done. But what is the flag for? What are you flagging for? Holding offense. Cecil's short, so we're going to go back to 1st and 17. Not good. And the offense can string something together, but they'll need to do it quickly here to let's see to what we can do. Now got it. Go on, Safarian Jenkins. Brilliant run. Getting right up. I think we're on the 10-yard, almost on the 10-yard line. So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense. Come on, then. Coaches really don't care. Rodgers now to make the run. But run after the catch ability, rack ability. That's it. Beautifully run. Taking some nice positive yards. Call it a gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it second. They've had a better average on the running game, but we're still not giving up on it. We're still going with it. Tie game here. 2 minute warning. Defense really needs to try and keep this game tied. See if they can get the ball. See if we can't run it in then. So it's Buccaneer football as we welcome you. I think it'll be Martin making the run. And he's made the run. He's in. Touchdown. And we're back in the lead again. Second rushing touchdown of the game. 30-24. And there's the choice of either going for the 2 points or the 1 point and hope. And giving the defense a massive chance to win us the game almost. Martin doing absolutely brilliantly in there. Let's continue then. Point after. Extra point is good. 31-24. Now it's down to the defense. What can you do, defense? Oh, game is on the line. I've got to try and help these defense then. Needing points. What let's can I do? Here comes the Falcon offense now as they get set to take over here. Got caught, two of them there. And they're coming off a three and out. That's beautifully hit. Go with the zone cover. Okay, so how do you do that? How do you shake things up? You look at what you called before. And hit him. Yes. Another timeout as they've been pushed back 3rd and 6 now. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. They'll look to throw. And he's run out of play. But was it completed? No, 4th and 6. Brilliant. He couldn't get his feet in bounds. And now then, I'll go right out over here. This worked for me last time. And go. Back to throw. He's got time in the pocket. He's gonna let it fly. And it's gone. We've got the ball back. 1st and 10. 1 minute 24 to go. I'm sure we can just start taking the kneel now, can't we? So now let's reset here, Charles. They do have 2 times. I know, had to go for it. He had lots of time. Threw it long and too long. So here comes Winston. Jameis Winston to give us the first win of the season, hopefully. We held them there. Big end of big drive. Hold on to the lead. Just running it. If we can run, get a first down, then I think that'll be the end of the game. Hey, I'm happy to keep going because they can take the time out if they want. It's fine with me, and we'll go into the next part because I'm sure we're going to... No, let's just go with the run. Let's just go with the run. I'm not giving them a chance. Let's go. Halfback smash. Second and 10. Chance to get through. That's all right. And they're going to call another timeout. Third and 8. I think we're at that point where we have to throw now, though. Let's see what the coach is saying. He wants to chew the clock. He wants to go back to the halfback blast again.
See if the defense tries any pressure here.
You never know. We might have enough just to tick away that 117. Especially if he does that. Straight through. Picking up brilliant yards and getting a first and 10. Meaning the clock can just tick away now. 30 seconds to help tick along. And we're going to take the kneel. We're so close, but we don't want to throw away the first win of the season. What's the point in that? And let's give it another 10 seconds or so. Let's go down as far as we can. 15 seconds to go. They're jumping around in the defense. They're trying to make sure they're all in position, hopefully trying to hit me. And kneel. There we go. And that should be it. That's it. 32 seconds on the play clock. 22 seconds to go. Might just take one more kneel. Have one more play in this match. Again, if I take another kneel, it's another yard taken away from the rushing. So, what's the point? I'll just let the 8 seconds, 7, 6... Five. Here comes the first win. Come on. 2-1. Boom. All done. Thank you very much. Winning the first game of the season. Tampa Bay 31. Atlanta 24. We certainly had the scare at the end of the second half, but not at the in the fourth quarter. Didn't let the nerves get to us this time. But thankfully, just like in real life, the Bucs leave the Georgia Dome with an absolutely huge victory. Great running from Martin. Some questionable throwing at times from Winston, but still getting a few touchdowns. Defense strong most of the time. Of course, there's always going to be things to iron out, but for today, we can enjoy the fact that one match in, we are winning, and we've won our first match. Brilliant. See you in the next episode.